Hello students, how are you all? I hope you all are doing fine. So in today's video, we are going to discuss another very important question from NEET 2022 biology paper. So are you all ready for the question? So let me read out the question for you all. The question is, which one of the following statements cannot be connected to predation? Let me read the options. The options are, it is necessitated by nature to maintain the ecological balance. Second option, it helps in maintaining species diversity in community. Third is, it might lead to extinction of species. And the fourth option is, both the interacting species are negatively impacted. So dear students, in this particular question, we have to find the wrong option, that is something which is not connected to predation. So dear students, to answer this question, we have to understand the concept of predation. So are you all ready for the concept? So let's start with the video. So dear students, when we talk about population, what exactly is population? Population is basically a group of organisms. So when we talk about population in general, there are so many different types of species which are present in this entire world. It can be a population of lions, it can be population of tigers, it can be a population of humans, etc. and etc. It can be even the population of plants. So we all know that on this particular planet Earth, there is an interaction between different types of species. So what are the different types of interactions? So let us understand what are the different types of interaction. The interactions can be, it can be mutualism, it can be competition, it can be predation, parasitism, commensalism and ammensalism. So dear students, in this particular table, you can see that there are some signs which are been mentioned. Like for example, in case of mutualism, you can see that species A and species B both have plus signs, whereas in case of competition, both species A and species B have got negative signs. So what do we understand by this? So dear students, here always remember, plus sign means basically the species is benefited from the other species. So for example, in case of mutualism, since there is plus sign in case of species A and species B, that means both the species are benefiting each other. Whereas in case of competition, since there is a negative sign in case of species A and B, that means both are actually harming each other. They are not benefiting each other, they are in fact harming each other. So now let us see one by one each of these population interactions. Now dear students, the very first type of population interaction, as we said, is mutualism. What do we understand by this word mutualism? Mutual is something that means that both the organisms actually are benefiting each other, right? So in nature, there are so many beautiful examples of mutualism. One of the very common examples which we can relate is, we all know about pollination. Dear students, what is pollination? We all know that in pollination, basically the birds or either the insects are helping the plants for pollination. That means they are helping the plant to transfer the pollen grains from one plant to the other plant. So dear students, in this type of interaction, basically the plants are benefiting the insects or the birds by providing them nourishment. That is nothing but the nectar. At the same time, the birds are helping the plants in pollination. That is helping them in carrying the pollen grains from one plant to the another. So likewise, in nature, there are so many other examples of mutualism. Let me give you some common examples of mutualism. One of the very common example is lichens. Now, dear students, this is a very beautiful example of mutualism. Lichens, basically lichens are nothing but a combination of algae and fungi. That means these two organisms, that is algae and fungi, are living together. They are in close relationship with each other. Now dear students, in case of lichens, the algae benefits the fungi by helping them, by giving them the shelter, as well as also helping them by providing them nourishment in the form of food, because we all know that algae can photosynthesize. That means algae can make their own food, right? Whereas the fungi is benefiting the algae by helping in the absorption of nutrients. You may think, where are these exactly lichens growing? So these lichens actually grow on the bark of trees. Lichens also grow basically in the colder regions like the Antarctic regions. and they are present on the rocks, etc. So that's why, dear students, they are also basically indicators of pollution. Why? Because they cannot survive in the cities. They cannot survive in the areas where there is a lot of pollution. Now going further, there is another example of mutualism. This is nothing but a nitrogen fixing bacteria which is called as Rhizobium. Now dear students, Rhizobium are present inside the root nodules of certain leguminous plants. The very common example of leguminous plant is pea plant, that is nothing but commonly called as garden pea. So inside these root nodules, this bacteria called as Rhizobium basically survive. So how do they help the plants? They help the plant in the atmospheric nitrogen fixation. That is, they help the plants in converting the atmospheric nitrogen into the soluble form of nitrogen, that is nitrites as well as nitrates. And how does the plant benefit the bacteria Rhizobium? The plants benefit the bacteria by giving them the shelter. Now dear students, this is another very important type of a population interaction. This is known as competition. Now dear students, in nature, we all know that there is a high amount of competition among the members of the same population which belong to actually the same species, or sometimes it can be competition between the members of the populations of different species also. Sometimes it can be competition between different genuses also. So for example, in this particular pic, as we can see that there is a competition, there is a fight among the two lions, and these two lions can fight for common food, they can also fight for common space, they can also fight for their mates. So as we said that, dear students, the members of the population are fighting with each other. So do you think that the members of this population are benefiting each other? Not at all. So in fact, dear students, the members are actually harming each other. So in this type of population interaction, that is competition, both the members are harming each other. They are not at all benefiting from each other. Now dear students, the third type of population interaction we see in nature is something called as parasitism. Now what is parasitism? Now dear students, in parasitism, one species actually grows on the other species. That means one species derives benefit from the other species, whereas the other species is known as the host. So in nature, there are multiple examples of parasites. Now dear students, here one species benefits from the other species by actually gaining nutrition from the other species, or it can get shelter from the other species, but basically it is also harming the other species, dear students, in the form of it can cause some or the other disease in the host. So let us see some examples of parasites. Here a very common example of parasites is ticks, which actually grows on the body of animals. So generally these are often found on the skin of dogs, cats, etc. There is also another very common example of parasite, and that is nothing but the malarial parasite. Dear students, we all know it is known as Plasmodium. So this particular Plasmodium, which is actually a type of protozoan, is present inside the body of a female mosquito, which is known as female anopheles. And it is via this mosquito, this Plasmodium can enter inside the human host. So dear students, this parasite, that is Plasmodium, once it enters inside the human host, can multiply inside the human host and also form its higher advanced stages. So dear students, that means here the Plasmodium is getting benefited from the humans because it is getting the shelter as well as the nourishment from the humans, but the humans are getting the disease because of that particular Plasmodium, and we all know the disease is known as malaria, which is quite a dangerous form of disease. Another very important common type of population interaction, this is known as predation. Dear students, in nature there are so many examples of predation. It can be basically a lion which is killing deer for its food. But dear students, predation does not necessarily always mean that one animal is trying to kill the other animal. Predation can also simply mean an insect which is eating a seed, or a bird which is eating a seed. It can also mean that a herbivorous animal, like for example a cattle or a sheep which is eating a grass, it can also be considered as a predation. So dear students, let us understand why predation is important. Now dear students, predation is very very important because it helps in maintaining the balance of energy inside the ecosystem. That means basically you can see the diagram of a food chain in this particular slide. So as we all know, in the food chain, the producers are nothing but the plants which actually make their own food. But this energy is transferred to the herbivores which actually feed on the plants. In the herbivores we have examples like sheep or cattle, etc. And likewise, the herbivores transfer their energy to the primary consumers. The primary consumers will further transfer it to the secondary consumers. And that's how the energy is transferred from one type of organism to the other organism. Now dear students, in nature this is very important because it helps in maintaining the energy in the ecosystem. Otherwise dear students, the energy can get accumulated in only one type of organism and this can cause ecological imbalance. So that's why dear students, predation helps in maintaining the flow of energy. Now dear students, there is also very another important role of predation. Back in 1920s in Australia, there was an incident of the classic invasion of prickly pear cactus. The local plants were unable to survive. So as a result of which, there was a need for a predator which can actually kill this prickly pear plants. So thus there was a predator moth which was introduced in Australia, and that moth, dear students, helped in killing the prickly pear cactus. Dear students, there is also another important role of predators. The predators also help in basically overcoming the competition among the different species. Here is a classic example of a predator which is known as Starfish Pisaster. Now dear students, this particular starfish predator was present in the American Pacific coast and it actually helped in maintaining the population of fishes in that particular Pacific coast. But dear students, as soon as this particular predator was removed from that Pacific coast, the population of fishes went down and down, and as a result of which it even resulted in the extinction of some of the species of fishes. That means dear students, here there is a classic example of predator which is also helping in maintaining the population of a species. Another important type of a population interaction, it is called as commensalism. Now what is commensalism? Now dear students, in commensalism, one species gets the benefit from the other species, but the other species neither gets the benefit nor is harmed by the other species. Let's see the example of commensalism. Now dear students, very beautiful example of commensalism in nature is cattle egrets. Now cattle egrets are quite often present on the back of the animals like the cattle. So basically the cattle egrets get benefited because of the cattle, because when the cattle are actually grazing, sometimes the seeds get stuck to their skin and the cattle egrets can feed on those seeds. So the cattle egrets are getting the nourishment from those seeds. But dear students, are the cattle getting any benefit from the egrets? The answer is no. Are they harming the cattle? The answer is again no. So here, that means dear students, the cattle are benefiting the egrets, right? But the egrets are neither benefiting the cattle nor are harming the cattle. So such a type of a relationship is called as commensalism. This is also a very good example of commensalism. This is an example of a shark and a silverfish. So in the oceans dear students, these silverfishes often swim along with the large shark fish. And the reason is, whenever the shark feeds on a particular prey, the leftover pieces which come behind are often eaten by the silverfish. So here again dear students, we can see that the silverfish is getting benefit from the shark, but the sharks are neither getting any benefit from silverfish nor are getting harmed by the silverfish. So this is again a good example of commensalism. Now the last type of population interaction dear students is known as ammensalism. In case of ammensalism dear students, one species is actually getting harmed because of the other species. Whereas the other species is neither getting harmed nor getting benefit because of the other species. Let's see what is the example of emmensalism. So the example is between the goat and the insects. Now dear students, whenever the goats actually feed on the grasses, there are small insects sometimes which are present inside the grasses. So whenever the goat is actually feeding on the grass, it might harm or even kill the insect. So in this type of interaction where the insect is getting harmed, whereas the goat is neither getting harm from the insect nor getting benefit out of the insect. Another example of emmensalism is the cattle walking on the grass. So here dear students, whenever the cattle is actually walking on the grass is getting harmed, but the cattle is neither getting harmed nor getting benefit out of the grass. So dear students, I hope you have understood different types of population interactions. Now dear students, since we have understood the different types of population interactions, we can easily make out the answer of this question. Here the fourth option, which is nothing but both the interacting species are negatively impacted, is basically a wrong option, and this is the one which can be the right answer. Because here in the option, dear students, they are saying that both the interacting species are negatively impacted. Whereas in the predation, we saw that one species is getting benefit from the other species. So dear students, I hope you have understood the concept of different types of population interactions. And I hope that you have also understood the question and the answer which has come in NEET 2022 question paper. If you have any doubts or suggestions, please put it in the comment section. You can also mail me on my email ID, dear students, which I have mentioned in the description box. If you have understood the concept, please like, share and subscribe to One Page Biology. I will be seeing you all in the next video with some another biology related concept, dear students. See you all in the next video. Till that time, take care. Bye bye. Thank you so much.